No, we will regret in this study.
Look at this goat.
I want it prepared to travel to the capital for trial.
Fuck you!
And leave us.
You walk a dangerous life.
I'll cut your fucking head off.
But it is still a threat. I will not ignore it.
I did everything I could to close the breach. It almost killed me.
Yet you live. A convenient result insofar as you're concerned.
Have a care, Chancellor. The breach is not the only threat we face.
Someone was behind the explosion at the conclave. Someone most holy did not expect.
I'm gonna kill you.
Perhaps they died with the others.
Stupid old ass bitch.
Have allies who yet live.
I am a suspect?
Gee.
And many others.
But not the prisoner.
I heard the voices in the temple. The divine called to him for help.
So he survived. That thing on his hand. All a coincidence.
Providence. The Maker sent him to us in our darkest hour.
You can't honestly believe I'm any kind of chosen one.
We are all subject to the will of the Maker, whether we wish it or not. No matter what you are or what you believe, you are exactly what we needed when we needed it.
The breach remains, and your mark is still our only hope of closing it.
This is not for you to decide.
You know what this is, Chancellor. A writ from the divine, granting us the authority to act. As of this moment, I declare the Inquisition reborn. We will close the breach, we will find those responsible, and we will restore order, with or without your approval.
This is the divine's directive. Rebuild the Inquisition of old. Find those who will stand against the chaos. We aren't ready. We have no leader, no numbers, and now no Chancellor support.
But we have no choice. We must act now, with you at our side.
If you're truly trying to restore order...
That is the plan.
Help us fix this before it's too late.
Ugh, the face. The face, though. It's pretty ugly. Don't tell me they made me read that whole fucking book. Thank you. Dragon Age Inquisition. That was the longest ass intro I've ever seen.
Does it trouble you?
I wish I could get rid of it.
We have need of it yet.
So you've mentioned.
What's important is that your mark is now stable, as is the breach. You've given us time, and Solas believes the second attempt might succeed, provided the mark has more power. The same level of power used to open the breach in the first place. That is not easy to come by.
What harm could there be in powering up something we barely understand?
Hold on to that sense of humor. You've met Commander Cullen, leader of the Inquisition forces.
It was only for a moment on the field. I'm pleased you survived.
This is Lady Josephine Montelier, our ambassador and chief diplomat.
I've had much. It's a pleasure to meet you at last.
And of course you know Sister Liliana.
My position here involves a degree of...
She is our spymaster.
Yes, tactfully put, Cassandra.
Pleased to meet you all.
I mentioned that your mark needs more power to close the breach for good.
Which means we must approach the rebel mages for help.
And I still disagree.
She's still in my games! She's a thief!
Enough magic poured into that mark.
What?
Might destroy us all. Templars could suppress the breach. We can...
You thief!
I was a Templar. I know what they're capable of.
Unfortunately, neither group will even speak to us yet. The Chantry has denounced the Inquisition, and you specifically.
That didn't take long.
Shouldn't they be busy arguing over who's going to become divine?
Some are calling you the Herald of Andraste, and that frightens the Chantry. The remaining clerics have declared it blasphemy, and we heretics for harboring.
Chancellor Roderick's doing, no doubt.
It limits our options. Approaching the mages or Templars for help is currently out of the question.
Will the Chantry attack us? With what? They have only words at their disposal.
And yet, they may bury us with them. There is something we can do. A Chantry cleric by the name of Mother Giselle has asked to speak to you. She is not far and knows those involved far better than I. Her assistance could be invaluable.
I'll see what she has to say.
You will find Mother Giselle tending to the wounded in the hinterlands near Retcliffe.
Look for other opportunities to expand the Inquisition's influence while you're there.
We need agents to extend our reach beyond this valley, and you're better suited than anyone to recruit them.
In the meantime, let's think of other options. I won't leave this all to the Herald.
Thank you.
That'd be stupid. Like you.
Boys.
That can't they watch in there? I don't want to hear Jake's mouth.
I've heard the stories. Everyone has. We know what you did at the breach. It's an honor to meet you, my lord. Inquisition Scout Harding, at your service. I, all of us here, will do whatever we can to help.
Harding, huh? Ever been to Kirkwall's High Town?
I can't say I have. Why?
You'd be Harding in a... No, never mind.
Ugh.
It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
We should get to business. The situation's pretty dire. We came to secure horses from Redcliff's old horsemaster. I grew up here, and people always said that Dennett's herds were the strongest and the fastest this side of the Frostbacks. But with the Mage Templar fighting getting worse, we couldn't get to Dennett. Maker only knows if he's even still alive. Mother Giselle's at the crossroads helping refugees and wounded. Our latest reports say that the war spread there too. Corporal Vale and our men are doing what they can to help protect the people, but they won't be able to hold out very long. You best get going. No time to lose.